So you called me. Say what?
Oh yeah.
I'm about to say what is about to call.
Yeah, it looked like he was gonna call offensive foul or something like that, but on Ryan, but Ryan slipped the screen.
Mm-hmm. Oh, big fella did came up and knocked him. You gotta be careful. Hurt somebody's leg like
yeah,
that. But he already
did. Yeah, he came late. He came late on that.
It's funny how they try to fight the position.
Here's Johnson working on Stevens. Back to Pargo, the three. And he doesn't miss. He doesn't miss. And he's right there. Even though he made the shot, that play was for Hollins to hit.
He just had to play Flair.
Both
Flair
and Flair.
He didn't hit right there.
Yeah. Oh, it lost it. Stevens got it back for him. Izochef, the three. Box out, Joe.
Yeah, he's going to need some scoring down the pitch. I can see him.
Throws it to Hollins. Stevens got it back from the angle. Here's Bullet for three. Yes. Triplets just 9 points away from victory. And you can see the difference with the Triplets. You have two guards, the Pargo brothers that can spread the court.
Yeah.
We're not even talking about Joe being able to shoot. So with Bullet and Aliens, you got one guard that has to try to do everything, not only to get his teammates some shots, but he got to make buckets. That's a heavy burden to carry, especially when you're playing against a championship kind of a team like the Triplets. Jeremy Pargo tried to throw that up to Hollins. They say no basket. Hey, Scout, what can you give us some insight here on this alien squad?
Yeah, you guys got to know that Carlos Basmanis is the number one player in the world. He plays for Latvia. He had to go back to play for the world championship. He had 18 the other night, and he's a guy that spreads the floor, can shoot off the move. Like, exactly what you guys are talking about is exactly what they need. Well, he's out this week because of FIBA 3-on-3 responsibilities.
Right. Hey, Scott, when you look at him, he's 6'7". He adds value to that, but do you still think that another guard also helps with that, having two bigs that can pop, pick and pop?
Yeah, when it comes to these guys, I don't actually know how they're going to rotate their guys. But if one thing you guys keep bringing up is shot making and spacing.
Right.
Basmanis provides that for this team.
Okay. So we got a challenge of bringing the fire.
About time.
And here's the deal. You can challenge a shooting foul. You challenge that, you bring the fire. Defensively, you make a stop, you get the basketball. Two bigs. When last time we see the like this run, we'll see what Brian does for 10 seconds. Now, the beauty of it too, you got 10 seconds on the clock to kind of make your move.
Yeah.
You don't have to be in a hurry, but you got to be decisive in what you want to do.
Yeah, because if you foul again, you get a free point.
Who are you taking, Nate? Come on, Nate. Evil Chef's out.
It's Hollins and Stevens.
I'm going with Stevens.
And usually it's the defense that's come up big in these. I think they have the advantage thus far when you look at the numbers of bringing the fire.
See the jab step right there. You
that
see
was
that?
I told you. The defense is going to win. Tragic Johnson can't beat it. I watched Brian Hines play a lot of basketball at UCLA and in the league. Nah, it's not cutting it. His offensive abilities is subpar. He's a good shot blocker, good rebounder, but offensive.
So far, the defense reigns.
Yeah.
Out of the 10, bring the fire. They won 7 of them.
I think I lost every ring of fire the last year. They was going at me. I was laying the ball. I'm like, bro, what's going on? I didn't get one, bro.
Oh, good pass.
You gotta catch that first. That's a dime.
Oh, man, that is. Very nice. He's looking up right there.
Yeah.
Pargo will throw it in to Holland.
Give it up. One thing Ryan can do is catch lobs, though. Get his hands off.
So
Jeremy Pargo will inbound it for the Triplets. Still just 9 points away from victory.
The sun got mad, man. He got to get cooked all day today. The barbecue.
Here's Joe working on Steven.
He is playing great defense on Joe.
Pargo!
And they're killing.
What a
Pargo
shot.
Brothers are cooking up right now.
Yeah, you know what makes them so tough, too, the Pargo brothers. They don't just stand still. When they see...
They know how to play basketball.
Exactly.
Yeah,
there's an opportunity to the open spot. And speaking of open,
he's going to miss it. Here's Joe.
Oh.
Chef got a hand on it.
Look, when you know you got a scorer like Joe, the defense is man peekable. They're looking. Maybe you don't double team, but now you just get yourself to an open area. Joe's going to give it up.
Yeah, imagine. Joe second guessing every shot.
Here's Bullitt from the corner. That's no good. Rebound, Johnson. Pargo waves off Hollins, tells him to get out. He wants to go and pull it. Crosses him over, drives, and draws the foul.
Yeah. He knows what he wants. He wants the ISO. Get out of here, all right?
Cross. He should have just been in the lane anyway. If you kick it to Ryan, so what?
Yeah.
You know, it's not a big that's a space to floor and shoot it. Maybe if he's up a little bit more, Pargo doesn't get as close to the rim, doesn't pick up that foul.
Pargo will get close to Ryan up. That's what I'm talking about.
Jeremy knocks it down. He's got 18 points.
Brother's got 18 and 17 right now, taking it by storm.
Biggest lead here for the Triplets of the game. 5 points away from victory. And they've got the rock because they're the bonus. They go into Joe. He's got Bullitt on.
He got the mismatch he wanted.
Wanted this one. Oh, good cut. Backdoor cut. And he couldn't handle it.
Joe got to throw that to the rim, though. In all honesty.
Missed opportunity for the Triplets. Watch this cut.
Yeah, but they were Drexler.
Yeah, I'm throwing that to the basket. Throwing it to the basket up in the air. Go under that. Switch it. Just switch it. Flip with this two-pointer.
Oh, nice spin by Stevens.
He only got a flat tire.
Still got it in. Lead is 14. That's all good crossover. Pargo. Oh,
God, he didn't know where he was.
Fades. Shot is too strong.
Glad he didn't call that, did he?
I think Jim did.